Your life will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here to take.
Beloved, we thank God that you've joined us today on this Voice of Resurrection devotional. It's been a fantastic week. We've been learning so much from the Word of God. This is the Word that God gave to Joseph at the beginning when he had that dream visitation. The name Jesus was given to us by God to save us from our sin. Then after we receive Jesus, we enter into a personal encounter with him, and we would call him Emmanuel. Jesus has now meant that the Father is with me, the Father is indwelling me, the Father is ministering through me, the Father is working miracles by me, the Father is delivering people through me, the Father is doing mighty works and wonders in my life. Beloved, it's such a great mystery. And we will be studying it all through this month. Hallelujah. Listen to John 14 once again as we round up this week. Jesus said, verse 7, if you had known me, you should have known my Father also, because we are one. And from henceforth you know him and have seen him. Philip said unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and we'll be satisfied. Jesus said unto him, have I been so long time with you, and yet hast thou not known me, Philip? He that hath seen me has seen the Father. And how sayest thou then, show us the Father? Believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? You see, beloved, that's why I wanted to talk about this again. He said, believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? You notice the same way Philip had to believe, looking at a physical Jesus, that he was the representative of the Father, that he was the Father revealed. So must you and I believe that with Jesus in our hearts, by his Spirit, that the Father is in us. I have to believe it. So the works that the Father does will manifest. I have to believe that he that is in me is greater than he that is in the world. He that is in the world is Satan. He that is in the world is demonic spirits and principalities and powers. We pay them no mind. We concentrate on discovering the God in me, the Father in me, through Jesus Christ. I have to believe that he's in me. I have to believe that he's with me. I have to believe that he will manifest himself through me. Glory to God. This is so powerful, beloved. This will change our lives if we will grab a hold of it. In the name of Jesus. He said, believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. The Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works, beloved. I have to believe it, and then the Father will start showing out in my life. I have to believe it, and the Father will start manifesting and demonstrating in my life. I have to believe it, so the Father will disprove all lying devils and lying naysayers in the name of Jesus, and you will rise from obscurity, you will rise from the dust, you will rise from your predicament into the glory, into the glorious liberty of the children of God, into the manifested power of God. You will no longer be a weakling. You will be a giant. You'll be a giant killer because of the Lord your God manifesting through you, manifesting in you, manifesting for you. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Listen to it. Let's read some more. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very work's sake. I am so glad, beloved, that this is not something we talk about. That this is something we demonstrate. Emmanuel is for real. The presence of the living Christ. Many times I've been in meetings and they may be going, and I just come and stand on the podium and I pause for a moment and I say, Hallelujah. Boom! And the glory will just explode all over the room. All over the room. I was in a conference recently and I was asked a question. The moment I stood up to speak, boom, the glory filled the room. That's Emmanuel, the manifestation of the Father, the manifestation of His presence, His glory in my life. I pray that you will sense His presence and His glory as we study and share in this devotional. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also, and greater works. Can you believe greater works than these shall he do? Because I go unto my Father. Jesus says, the Father was in me when I was down here, but now I am going up to him, and I will be sitting at his right hand, and I will be interceding for you. And now the Father will even do greater through you than he did through me. Isn't that something? Wow. Isn't that something? And then, and unfortunately, we haven't even been able to do what Jesus did. Only a few people have been able to do that. Oh, beloved, I pray that we will start measuring on obedience. Let me throw it in before we go because my time is up. Remember verse 21 again. Say, he that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him, and I will manifest myself to him. See, obedience will bring manifestation and the revelation of Jesus. Judas said unto him, Lord, how is it that thou wilt manifest thyself unto us and not unto the world? Jesus answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words. And my Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. You see, he will live with me, and then he will direct me, he will move me into this realm of glory, and we will do greater works in these last days. And to revive our brethren, that we'll all come back and start seeking God and consecrating ourselves and serving him, and then we will reach the world for him in these last days. Oh, beloved, join the fight. Join the army of the Lord. We love you. We will see you next week. Pastor Chico Onozo. Bye-bye.
Waiting.